All right. Welcome to this section on Defender for IoT around protocols and dissectors. So I am James Dykowski, Global Black Belt for the Defender for IoT platform. So first of all, what we'll do is start with the overall purpose of a dissector. And what that is effectively a means for the Defender for IoT engine to be able to pull out protocol information from the packets that are running across the wire. In general, anything new would have to be, it would be something proprietary, or if it's a new industry or something like that. So in this case, what we've done is added in the DICOM dissector, which you can see right here. And so now as PCAPs are running, basically we're capturing the data from the packets running across the wire. We're pulling out the asset information and also the protocol information for this, this new dissector, this new protocol. So the first thing that we'll show is just an individual entity here. So this is known as a server in this world. We're labeling it this just because it's an entity that's running that protocol. And then here, anything management-wise, we'll consider that a workstation by default. And so now inside of this, we can actually see connection details. So now we can see the traffic by port, as well as, so understanding that DICOM is running on 8104, but then also how much traffic is going across this wire, how much throughput is there, as well as just over a custom range or a longer period of time and such. So that is the first piece that we show there. Let me get myself out of the way. And so the next item to note is when we look at, let me unselect this, a particular asset and we select view properties. And we show this in a tabular form in asset inventory, and I'll show in a second, but we are pulling out the name of the asset. We do understand the vendor automatically, operating system, all the standard things that we would understand because we are doing deep packet inspection across the wire. So we can understand IP address, MAC address, but now additionally, we're understanding that DICOM's running protocol-wise within this asset. Another note is in the normal scenario, we understand, is this something that scans the network commonly? Is it something that we need to enable so that we don't get false alarms? And then also, is this asset an asset that's already been authorized or is it a new asset that's come online? So then you will be notified if there are new assets that do come online, all the same as any other time. So now I'm going to go back one step and show how did I put this in here since I've kind of showed the meat. So here you can see, DICOM monitoring. We can see any packets that are going across the wire right now. Just while this is running, there haven't been any packets, right, for the last 10 or so. And so this will continually manage just the way that it always does. But it's something that, operationally, if somebody wanted to dig in and see details of what's going on inside the network, this is an option for them. Another note is that now that we have a dissector that can basically pull out and understand this protocol, we can create custom alert rules from within this Horizon plugin. This is an SDK. So now I have DICOM built in here. Let me step back one second. So to add this DICOM in here, you literally just select upload and then pull in an HDP file that we basically build very quickly and pop it in here, and then it automatically starts working. So, and then it populates in here into this list, and then you can manipulate however you see fit. But now that we have this ability to look at, say, this abort command sent, so the operational engineer, whoever, or maybe they actually have, somebody from some vendor that really cares about DICOM, that's what's running in their platform, and they want to understand when aborts are happening or when associate rejects are happening, which you can see the next line down, then we can literally customize and create alerts based on what that is. So you can see I threw DICOM in here, make it very explicit. And then saying abort command has been seen. And what that is inside the DICOM protocol, there's a PDU type. And so that'll be set to value 7. There are other flags that we can pull out, destination, source, all kinds of different items to be more granular with the details here. But just to understand what the capabilities are now that you have this dissector in place. So this is the abort command example. And then here you can see an associate reject example. And in the messages, you know, I pulled out some specific details from the actual specifications, but you can put anything in here. It's nothing. And so you can see this here, it's associated value of 3 for the PDU type that's running within the protocol. So nonetheless, that's kind of the quick piece about how just custom alerts are sent based on literally anything that they wanted to manage. So if we go in here, I'm going to take one step further from the asset map and just show you do have the available entities in the tabular form. These can all be exported via Excel, PDF, whatever you want. And now that we do have this protocol in here, we can select value and it does automatically populate here. So now we can filter down to any DICOM assets or any assets that are running the DICOM protocol right here. We can see vendors, MAC addresses, all the same information that we saw before. And then of course you can actually manipulate these tabs or these columns, I should say, as you see fit. And then another note is in the alerts, we should see our DICOM alerts populate. So now we have a DICOM associate reject command send, okay? So now these are the same details I put into the custom alert, and now they have a means for managing this. We can see the system that was sourced and destination. We can log this. We can do all of the same, download related PCAPs, all the same necessary debugging or any kind of investigation requirements that you want. Or if this is okay in this time because somebody was testing or you understand that there was something going on, you can just simply acknowledge it and move on. Here's the abort command set. So just another pull of a different type of failure command. And so this is the actual definition from the protocol spec itself. Now say that, and I'm not 100% sure, it looks similar. Say this workstation is a problem all around, and maybe it is the same as the other event here. We can then, just like any other alert, investigate further. Say this is, maybe there's malware also associated to this, this particular server. So we can actually click on it and see whom else is this guy talking to inside of the network and what are our risks and threat hunting capabilities that we need to be aware of, right? So nonetheless, you have all those abilities all the same as you do with any other protocol. Everything plugs and plays very simply into the Defender for IoT engines. Okay, and then getting really down and dirty, operationally, if a customer really wanted to dig into the protocol and understand what's going on, you can create a new report. In this case, I already have the report, so I don't have to mess up clicking around. But you can see here, DICOM is automatically populated, okay? You populate with a name, and then you run the report, and it gives you all the available details. Anything that you would need to really know about this protocol when it comes to AE titles, which is specific to the DICOM protocol, as well as those PDU types, which I talked about before. And so you can actually see the value right here. So you can see associate accept, right? This release RP. This is just the data transmission. DICOM is a imaging protocol, so there's a lot of data passed through across the wire. And even something like a CC Connect confirm. Say we wanted to add another alert because this is something that we want to be made aware of because now it's potentially going to write to a device once it has a full confirmation of connecting. But then you can also see we should be able to find a reject, so here's associate request, or we should be able to see the the abort command, because we know we had the alert before, and I'm probably just missing it. Okay, so here's an associate reject right here. Oh, and here's an abort right here. So, and the associated PDU 3 and 7. So it is literally pulling when this packet comes across the wire and creating that alert just like we would expect. And so now they're made aware of on the operation side, assuming that this is an operational risk, what's happening, and they can be made aware of it and they can manage this event as they push forward. And then the last bit of details, they have protocol version right here. So just obviously a common thing that that they may want to be made aware of, depending on the protocol, right? Depending on all that kind of information. So investigation, asset management, alerts, all of this stuff is made available once you do create a dissector and have just the simplest amount of data available to be able to pull out what effectively the protocol is running. So that sums us up for this section right here. Really appreciate you listening, and let me figure out how to stop recording. And thank you for joining. Bye.